I'm putting a new piece for display at the Kangaroo Island Gallery. It's only on the wall to show you what it looks like. It's also available as a card, and now it's available in a frame. It should be accepted, I hope it is. In the event that it's not, it's still available for you to buy, whether you're here on the Kangaroo Island or on the mainland. His name is Punked Pelican. He was photographed about 10 years ago when we were visiting Kangaroo Island. I had someone say today he looks like he's got coiffured, is that the right word? Like the back of a horse. First off, what I do, because it's a resealable bag which I've purchased in Chinatown approximately, I reckon probably well over 10 years ago. So I bought about 1,000 of these resealable bags for about $10-$15. When I first got my work uploaded to Redbubble, they were selling them in their own special little resealable bags, which they don't do anymore. You buy, they come in a really compressed paper package. I actually sell them. So what I do, I put them in and then I cut off the resealable part because they look ugly. Then what I do, it's all about appearance in the gallery, is I use sticky tape and we very carefully stick down the edges. Well, I say the edges, what I'm doing is I'm overlapping the plastic, the excess plastic on the sharper end, not the case, so that way when it's displayed, it always shows the nice artwork at the top and a clean, unbroken edge. If you had it other way up, you'd see the sticky tape. And I don't want people to see that. It's all about display. It's like as if you're presenting a tiny little frame. Once that's on, it's all correct. And you can see it's now ready to purchase. And I'll add that to the pile. Here is, I'm not going to deny, the picture's been worked, as in the colours have been brought out and the rust is really exacerbated and the colours have been pumped up to show the green wet grass. I can't tell you where these are, but I know they're buried in bushland over here on Kangaroo Island. And again, these were photographed well and truly before we moved over here. I'd say in somewhere between 10 and 15 years ago. Now, some people might say, Stephen, you've become a bit of a capitalist. I never really wasn't. I got interested in photography, started taking work, and then I did the research on professionals and realized that you either sell it, photography as a service, so you provide the ability to take photos of people's family or themselves for portrait work, so they can have it available for corporate display or for family wall display. And I liked the idea of being in that sort of business, but I also liked being able to photograph my own work on my own finds and locations and then sell that as a framed piece or as a card, a postcard, a canvas, a frame, a poster. This one here was one of the many that were displayed at my 2010, so it's now 2019, at my 2010 Sala exhibition in Adelaide, Sala being the South Australian Living Artists. And I had this amongst 19 frames. I'm always thinking of new ways to display my art. And I like this one. The point is I'm now living on Kangaroo Island. I photograph local locations and scenery and organics and abstracts and landscapes. I'll put some links either below on the screen or in the description below, and you can see my artwork online. Aha! Uh-huh. Do you know this location? This is on the wharf in front of the jetty, a massive shed. As you can see, I've coloured it. It was blue, and then got painted a ghastly green. I've been taking photographs here on Kangaroo Island for a very long time. Yes, I have the luxury of having family that live here. Most recently, I bought a glide cam, but since found out the brand name, ultimately it's a piece of. I've tested it. Very hard to balance. It just proved to be very twitchy when it came to adjusting the plate, the top plate, left and right and backwards and forwards. So twitchy, so difficult to stay in just the right position that I'm not actually still convinced it's a good idea. Yes, it cost me, after postage and delivery, about $80. So I'm not giving up. I'm just saying that we're going to spend a bit more time getting it right. I've got my EOS M with 22mm mounted on it. No camera strap as shown in the video. No microphone on top. It's just a camera. Because I found out the hard way that having all those extra bits actually changes the balance. So if you tip the glide cam back with the strap on it, it just changes the weight just enough that it doesn't work as well as it should. Anybody recognise that? That's Remarkable Rocks. It's a great place to visit, and it can be photographed in so many different directions that you can display a unique photo every time. Here's one of my personal favourites. This is the Cape de Coude Lighthouse. I'll put a Wikipedia link showing the correct spelling. In the near future, I'm going to have this printed big enough to put into one of my 40 by 50 centimetre frames so that you can have that option of buying it big. I may even get posters, but we'll see how well these sell first. Would you buy this at a poster size or frame size or even on a canvas? I like creating. I like being creative with the world around me, with objects. And I've managed to find most recently a couple of old fence posts, and you might think, fence posts? What? How could that be art? Well, I have a suspicion these fence posts are well and truly over 50 years old, maybe even close to 100 years old. And I guess you wouldn't know. I mean, how would you know? How would you age something well enough? So I finished my day here at the gallery at around 5 o'clock. It's a longish day, but it's a working day. It allows for people who finish work and say, I've got to get a card for so-and-so's birthday, or that wedding I'm going to, or even that funeral I'm going to. Mother's Day or Father's Day, another one. One of those cars very deep in the forest. Oh, in the forest. No, it's not a forest at all, but anyway. So if you've never visited the Kangaroo Island Gallery at 1 Murray Street behind the Kingscote Council building, opposite Ingram's, opposite their rear entrance to their plumbing supplies, you'll find the shop. If you come along, come visit, please. We encourage you to visit, because it's not just about buying art. It's about perusing art, seeing what the locals produce, not just for the purpose of selling, but for keeping sane, really. I mean, art is about sanity. It's about releasing that creative spirit inside you and seeing what it creates from either photography or pottery, jewellery, glassware. There's so many things in here. There's a woman who makes birdhouses out of all the wood she can find in her yard, or maybe she's found it down the beach. But if you're watching this now and you're saying, you know, that guy makes some funny videos or interesting videos or informative videos, or he knows how to talk, then please take a moment to hit the notifications bell. and hit the subscribe button. You hit that like button.
Woohoo! Look at that!
Touch them hard enough for them to.
Woohoo! Look at that!
Subscribe to my channel. You now get notified when I put up new videos. And you like what you see. I've got more cards on display here at the KI Gallery. And you're welcome to come visit any time to take a look, to peruse, and hopefully purchase artwork for every occasion and amazing places and moments.